Hi all, thanks for stopping by my channel.
Today I want to speak a bit about applied neuroscience for sports. This is extremely complicated, but I will try to make it as simple as possible. You can study this subject for a lifetime without learning everything. The brain is like an organic computer that stores and changes and adapts to everything it's subjected to. It contains information from your first moment to your last. And via the wiring, the outer nervous system, it's connected to the muscles. The vestibular system in the inner ear helps with gathering and storing information like spatial awareness and balance in different positions. So, if you are doing a sport, your vestibular system helps providing with gathering and storing information about what positions your body is in when you are moving, and also how to keep balance when you're moving, during movements and transitions. This information is stored and used for later, so the movements get more and more economic and fluent, as well as natural. There is also a carryover, so if you train a couple of sports, you get advantages in the next one you are trying, and so forth. So some skills is general, and some is sport-specific. Here to the right you can see brain activity during exercise and while not exercising. To the left you can see the inner nervous system, the brain, as well as the outer nervous system. The outer nervous system as well can be changed by activities. So for example, if you train some movements a lot, it can change both the width and the connections, so you get control over more of the muscle. That in conjunction with that you are going to get more relaxed in the muscles that are not involved in the movement you are doing is going to make the movement more economic and natural and faster. The third picture in the middle shows a bit how it works when nerve cells are changed to meet the demand of the movement you are doing. So when you are beginner, it's not going to be natural and it reconnects, so the lead the electric impulses easier. It's partly because of that you can't expect beginners to do perfect movements. Some people say that you need perfect practice to make perfect, but in reality you need to see it as a big lump of clay that you are shaping first roughly, and when it starts to get closer to perfect you work more and more on the details. If you look at things a bit like a car, you have the engine and you have the electrical system. The body has the muscles and the nervous system. So if you have high numbers on squat, deadlift and bench press, you have a big motor. But it still can misfire and not getting used in the most efficient way. So you need to program the nervous system to get things in balance and work as good as possible. So you use the motor the best possible way you can. When you start, for example, learning how to swim, how to drive a car, or how to ride a bicycle, it's pretty complex and many movements that needs to get coordinated. But when you have done these several times, it gets stored as motor chains, so you have access to the information very fast and can coordinate the movements. So it becomes natural. You don't need to think when you're driving the car about each single step. And you don't need to think when you ride a bicycle. And you don't need to think when you swim. It gets automatic when you have learned it. So if you're very active and have learned 4 or 5 sports, not at a high level but a medium level or so, you should pick up the next sport easier and the next easier and so forth. Because you have the programming and the wiring to learn new skills. For example, if you have a gymnast who goes into boxing, he will pick up the movement patterns faster than somebody that hasn't had any training and don't have the neurological programming beforehand. Oftentimes when people train at the gym, they talk about the mind-to-muscle connection. When you're new to training at the gym, you don't have the neurological control over the muscles, so you don't feel the contact. And when you have trained for several years or decades, you have a lot more spread of the nervous system in the muscles, so you can contract the muscles more efficiently and feel control and hard contractions of almost every part of the muscle. So it adapts to the demand you put on it. Some examples of programming and cross training can be, for example, Zlatan Ibrahimovic. He is both a very good soccer player and he's trained in taekwondo. In Ultimate Fighting you have Anderson Silva. He's a very good dancer as well. And you also have George St. Pierre, also a fighter. And he trains a lot in gymnastics. When you program new motions in, you can go at slow speed, then medium speed, and then sport specific speed. You need to use all three to learn the movement as efficiently as possible. You can use the first two speeds to get a lot of repetition in and burn the movement in and store it in the nervous system. And when you do sports specific speed, it's a lot more demanding, of course, and it takes a longer time for the nervous system to recuperate after you do maximum speed movements. Slow and medium speed training is a great way to program the nervous system for movement. You can work more on details there. If you go at full speed, you tend to lose some control over the movement. So you basically program the body to contract the right muscle fibers at the right time. And also, when you log the information, you can log the body to be in different positions. For example, all the segments of a pose while running, and how you can get into a start position and explode out in the most efficient way. And that leads up to biomechanics, but that will be another video. But if you're used to being positioned good, it becomes natural to move in better movement patterns. And also if you sit a lot forward leaning with cell phones, you tend to get a hunchback and a tech neck. So you can program the body to keep itself in better positions, both while still standing and while moving. I hope you find the content interesting, and thanks a lot for watching. If you enjoyed the content, please like, subscribe and comment. See you next time. Thanks. Bye.